Radhe Radhe Govinda Govinda Radhe 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 Govinda Radhe.
It is the nature of greed that it will not let a person in peace until he has gotten.
You see, why greed is important?
Greed is money subject. There is no object. So our greed is money subject. That we not renounce, we cannot get object. And when I have an object and that subject come, is no problem. Thousands of subjects can come, but object is fixed. Your greed is for the object, not for the subject.
Clear?
Yeah.
That is our mistake. Our greed is only for the subject. That to renounce, make one object please, and make the greed for that, and then put the zeros after one. Too much value will come. If is there 1 zero or 10 zero, more value will come of subject. You have experience. You start praying for Prashad. You have 1 month money on you. Right? You say, I don't know after 1 month. Now you know something. You can run it or not. If the one object is fixed, subject come after that. So you don't need to bother, but never deviate for subject. Sorry to say, when we deviate for the subject and we reduce the object and our greed goes for the subject, we gone place. See that?
It is the nature of greed that it will not let a person in peace.
Never! Yeah.
And if the mind is not peaceful, mind is not peaceful, how you will know yourself, who are you, what is Sarup, and what is my object? First, I will not know the soul even. Too difficult for me. This is not my way, because my greed is different project. They suffer more. That has to renounce. When I say, Ghare thako, bane thako, ha gaurange bole thako, dharo tam mange tarsan. You are renounced or you are living in the forest? No meaning that. You fix your object. You renounce for what? Because my subjects are more important for me and no object is there. So we renounce, we become tired to renounce that. Are when you fix in the home your object, Why to renounce, yeah? But that only by the grace has been in life. Guru Kripa. And my smaran, my mind is relaxed to think that than a smaran. So always try to be relaxed, to move in this direction. Sri Ram.
It is the nature of greed that it will not let a person in peace until he has gotten the object of his desire.
Wow.
This means that when we think of something for a moment and the mind is drawn to something else, the next moment, we cannot really speak of genuine greed.
Yeah, though.
When the aspirant performs bhajan in allegiance to the acharyas, a tiny drop of their vast devotional greed may become infused in his heart. How sweet are the activities of Sriman Mahaprabhu's associates, whether they were householders or renunciants. They were all free from attachment.
Wow.
To sense gratification.
Yeah.
Their
sense gratification, many things. Not only one senses. Material greed is also sense gratification.
Fixed on the subject is sense gratification.
Yeah. Project fixed.
Yes.
Because the object is not there enough. That is the sanskar. This senses gratification is there, but you expand it up to there. Then we calculate my success when this becomes success. My God.
Yeah, because.
Why I said this thing? I was cross with these things. Experience, not thorough. I say without experience. I realize it by doing this sense gratification. First sense gratification I do, and after that, after living, also projects gratification also do. Object was not fixed, subject was fixed. One day, my Radha Mohan said, "Are what you are thinking for the subject? Think for me.
all subjects will be completed. From that day I realize and change myself. When he said to me, my eyes opened. Only he said to me, I listen that. And I changed myself that moment. Sri Ram. And it was, I see this. So very, very practical happening. And it only can realize by realization is enough.
Their auspicious dissension into the material world was meant for distributing tangible devotional experiences and detachment from sense gratification. Every mouthful of food causes nourishment, satisfaction, and cessation of hunger. In bodily consciousness, I cannot understand that I am Radha's maid servant. I just like to be connected with myself. Shri Narottam Das Thakur sings, the senses that dwell in our bodies are so many enemies. Nobody cares to stop them. My eyes see, but don't listen. And my heart knows, but does not realize. One thing is for sure, this body cannot stay. I'm chewing the thorns of sense gratification like a camel who cuts his mouth and tongue by chewing thorns instead of eating the mango pits of devotion like the cuckoo. I am burning to death in the fire of Maya, but still I will not relish the nectar of devotion. Shri Narottam Das Thakur sings, I consider the poison of sense gratification to be happiness, although I should know it to be miserable. Taste the nectar of Mohan subject and associate with his devotees. No, loving devotion
to be real. Mohan's service is blissful, and the lack of his service is misery. I desire service. Being surrounded by the Sakhis, that service contains the greatest bliss. When you love God, the divine remnants of that love will be scattered throughout the universe. Then you can experience universal love as it is. Then the material world is sweet, the spiritual world is sweet, and sweet Mohan is even more sweet. Sweetness will be pervading inside out. Swamini lies to rest on an excellent bed, covered with a bluish sheet. This sheet is very dear to her, simply because it reminds her of Mohan. She dreams of Mohan and his sweetness makes her happy inside and outside. Rupa Manjari and Tulasi can both admire her charming beauty and serve her limbs at that time. How wonderful is their love for Swamini. Rupa and Tulasi's friendship is similar in this material world, where they are known as Rupa Goswami and Raghunath Das Goswami. Srila Raghunath Das Goswami introduces himself as follows by writing in the end of his Vishakhanandada Sotram: "This garden of verses was strung by someone who subsists simply on serving the dust from Srimad Rupa Goswami's lotus feet. May the devotees who take shelter of him accept the fragrance of this garland." It is described in Bhakti Ratnakar that after reading Rupa Goswami's play Lalita Madhava, which describes Srimati Radharani's feelings of separation from Mohan, Srila Raghunath Das Goswami almost died of transcendental agony. just to save his life, Sri Rupa Goswami gave him Danakeli Komudi to read, a one-act play which deals with a blissful meeting of Radha and Mohan. This inspired Raghunath Das to write his jewel-like one-act play named Danakeli Chintamani. Shri Rupa Goswami has also written a dedication to Raghunath Das Goswami at the conclusion of his Danakeli Komudi. O Mohan, my friend Raghunath Das has given up all other activities and is now living in a cottage on the bank of Radhakund. Very anxious to exclusively serve you and Srimati Radharani. You always cast your merciful glance on those who live in Vrindavan, and you fulfill all their desires. So please quickly make the tree of Raghunath's aspirations bear fruit. These are some examples of their very intimate friendship. Tulasi and Rupa both climb on the bed to serve their Swami. They are not at all shy. Their servant mood is mixed with the mood of friendship for Swamini. Tulasi calls Swamini Manohya Hridaye. Girl with a beautiful heart. Literally, the word Manohya means knowing the mind. Srimati knows what is on Rupa and Tulasi's mind. So she gives them this service. Manohya also means beautiful one. Her endless beauty illuminates the house, the bed, and the hearts of the Kinkaris. Her luster has turned Mohan golden, making him appear as Gaura Sundara. She is the quintessence of Mahabhava personified. All the poetic analogies about her beauty, such as her face defeating the moon, her eyes defeating the lotus flowers, and her nose defeating the sesame flowers in beauty are ultimately futile. Only by her mercy, in the form of ecstatic love, can she be seen and felt in a heart illuminated by Vishuddha Sattva.
Yeah. What is the meaning of Vishuddha Sattva? Shuddha Sattva.
Ashuddha Sattva.
No, Shuddha Sattva. Sattva and Shuddha Sattva. Soul Sattva. Sattva? Sattva Guna.
Yes, yes.
Is a Guna.
Yes.
Out of Guna is soul. Shuddha Sattva. And Vishuddha Sattva is constitutional position, Sarup. Your spiritual identity, Manjari Bhava. Right?
That's for the beautiful.
Underline. Where you are staying? Check. Why not staying? Because of the lust. Many subjects is the goal. Object is not there.
Radhe Radhe Govinda.